A former Keene resident pleaded guilty today to a scam in which police say he faked cancer to get money from friends and well-wishers. 26-year-old Logan Henry, living in Barrie, Vermont now, is getting his one-year jail sentence deferred as long as he can pay back the nearly $3,800 he stole in the next 6 months. Adam Sexton joins us now to explain how the scam unraveled.
Well, Tiffany, police say in March, Logan Henry set up a website for himself to solicit donations for cancer treatment. Problem was, he didn't have cancer. His employers took notice, and they called police. Keene police say Logan Henry told a big lie to try to make a little money. In court Tuesday, Henry admitted to creating a webpage that said he had cancer and needed help with medical bills. The page, set up through the site GoFundMe.com, solicited donations, and police say Henry managed to get close to $4,000 from family, friends, and even people he didn't know.
Over 50 different people had donated money towards his cause, his alleged cause.
But when Henry's employers at CNS Wholesalers saw the page, they were skeptical. The regional claims manager forwarded information to Keene police that Logan Henry had been out of work since 2010 due to a shoulder injury and that no cancer treatment had taken place. When detectives showed Henry the records, they say he admitted he did not have cancer.
Once he was confronted by the police and they talked to him about what they knew, he confessed to what he had done and did admit to the scam.
In downtown Keene, people say it was a cynical, heartless ploy.
It's pretty messed up. I don't know why anybody would try to do that. Cancer's not something to mess around with.
It's completely ridiculous and obscene. It's really not fair for the people out there who actually have cancer, have disease, and actually need this money.
I think that's pretty low. I mean, that's taking advantage of people's sympathies, and that's pretty bad.
Henry admitted his guilt in court Tuesday and received a year-long jail sentence that will be deferred for 6 months so he can attempt to pay restitution and a $500 fine. Now, if Henry is able to pay restitution and that fine, his sentence will be suspended for 2 years. Of course, the deferment and the suspension of that sentence, are contingent upon good behavior. Reporting live in the newsroom, Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.